Good morning, students. Today I'm going to show you a few problems from exercise 10.4. Okay, before that, I want to discuss with you some of the most important theorems that is already have written. 10.8, the theorem is 10.8, the angle subtended by an arc at the center is double than the angle subtended by it at any point on the remaining part of the circle. This theorem is very important. The proof also sometimes coming, so you go through it, this theorem, and proof also you try, just written in your textbook. Okay, and if I'll get time, I'll explain you. Now you see, the theorem is what again? This you got it in class 8 also. If AB is an arc and that AB arc make a subtended angle at center, what angle? AOB. And the same AB arc subtended ADB, this angle at the remaining part of the circle. So now what is the relation between this angle and this angle? So this angle is double and this angle is the half. So angle AOB is equals to 60 degree. If angle AOB equals to 60 degree, then angle ADB must be half of 60 degrees, so 30 degree. Okay. So this is the theorem, is very, very important. Another theorem is there. That is also we are going to use. That is theorem number 10.9. Angle in the same segment of the circles are equal. Now, suppose this is the circle. Now, segments means you know AB is a chord. AB chord divides this circle into two part. One is this one, another is this part. Okay. Now, this is called minor segment, and that part is called major segment. So if I'll draw like this again, once again I'm drawing, this is the minor segment and this part is called major segment. Okay, now if I'll take two points E and D on the major segment, or minor segment also I can take. So now this AB chord makes angle ADB here in the same segment, and AEB another angle in the same segment. Okay, so these two angles must be equal because they are angle in the same segment and makes by the same arc or chord. So another theorem is there. Before I'll start the exercise, I want to discuss another theorem is there. This is also got in class 8. The sum of either pair of opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degrees. Now first of all, you know what is called cyclic quadrilateral. Now a quadrilateral ABCD is called a cyclic if all the four vertices of it lies on the circle. Now suppose this is the circle, and now here A, B, these two vertices lie on the circle, A, B, this is D, and this one is C. Suppose now if I'll join A, B, C, D, these four vertices lies on the circle of this quadrilateral, and this type of quadrilateral is called cyclic quadrilateral. And one property of cyclic quadrilateral is what? Sum of the opposite angles of the cyclic quadrilateral is equals to 180 degrees. Okay, so these are the few theorems which I am going to use to solve this exercise 10.5. Now 10.5, the first question which I have given you, here it is given. You see, very easy question. Here is angle BOC given 30 degree and angle AOB given 60 degree, and with the help of that they have asked to find out angle ADC. Now as you know, this AC arc subtended angle AOC at the center and ADC as the remaining part of the circle. So this is the, what is the relation between these two angles? They are half. So angle AOC is double than the angle ADC. So angle ADC equals to half of angle AOC. Now directly angle AOC is not given. In place of AOC it is given AOB. So we can add it, AOB plus BOC. So to get AOC. So 60 degree plus 30 degree, we have placed the value, and we are getting 90 degree. So half of it is 45 degree. Okay, and here don't forget to write the theorem what we are going used here. Now next we have, I think, question number 3 I have given you. Now question number 3, what is given? Given that angle PQR is 100 degree, and we have to find out OPR. Now you see, so here also same, this arc PR, this arc PR subtended angle PQR at the remaining part of the circle, and P POR, not this POR, inside knot. Huh? This is the exterior, that is reflex of POR. These two are relation, these two have relation. So we have written here reflex angle POR equals to twice angle PQR, because you remember that these two should be same direction. If it is this direction and this angle also should be same direction. Here you see, here we have drawn this angle and this angle, they are in the same direction, isn't it? Now, so in this way, we are finding out reflex of angle POR equals to twice angle PQR is 200 degree. Now, as we know reflex angle, so it is not we don't have problem to find out angle POR. So complete angle 360 minus this exterior part, then we'll get the interior of angle POR. So angle POR equals to 360 degree minus reflex angle POR, so we are getting 160 degree. Now, as this is a triangle and OP and OR are the radius, and we know radius of the same circles are same, equal in length. So, and another theorem also, you know, in a triangle, if two sides are equal, then the angle opposite to equal sides are equal. That means in that sense, angle OPR and angle ORP are equal. So here we have written angle opposite to the equal sides are equal, OP and ORP are same. Now, angle sum property have used that in this triangle, sum of these three angles, that angle OPR, angle ORP and angle POR is equals to 180 degree, written. So OPR and ORP are the same, just now we have grouped. So we can write here from 2. So in place of ORP, we have written OPR equals to 180 degree minus POR. POR value we know 160 degree. So twice angle OPR equals to 20 degree, and therefore angle OPR equals to 20 degree by 2 is 10 degree. So here it is, our answer. Now, next question, which one have given? Question number 8 I have given, I think. So here it is given. This question is a little bit important. What is given? If non-parallel sides of a trapezium are equal, prove that it is a cyclic. Now, you see here, trapezium means, you know, which is a only one pair is parallel. Here ABCD is a trapezium where AD is equals to BC. These are two non-parallel sides. Now we are going to prove that ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. Means you have to prove that the sum of the opposite angle goes to 180 degree. Then we can prove it is a cyclic quadrilateral. So for that, we have done one construction. We have drawn one PE line which is parallel to AD. So AB is parallel to DE given. As it is, AB is parallel to DC, so we can write AB is parallel to DE also. And AB, and AD is parallel to, AB is parallel to, AB is parallel to, here is it, AB is parallel to DE. AB is parallel to DE is given, and we have drawn by construction that is BE is parallel to AD. Okay, BD is parallel to AD. By construction, we have drawn that AD is parallel to BE. Okay, so in that sense, we are getting quadrilateral ABED is a parallelogram. Now, since it is a parallelogram, you know sum of the opposite angles equals to 100. Sorry, sum of the opposite angles are. Sorry, once again, sorry. Huh? So, since it is a parallelogram, so opposite angles are equal, you know. So, here written BAD equals to angle BED. BAD is equals to angle BED. Now, once again, AD is equals to BE. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal, here given name 2, but in our question AD is equals to BC given. In that sense BE equals to BC, so BE equals to BC. Okay, now so in this triangle BE equals to BC, therefore these two angles are also equal, angle opposite to equal sides are equal. Now so BEC equals to BCE we have written, because angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Now again, you see BEC and BED, these are what linear pair, 180 degrees. So you can write BEC plus BED, BEC plus BED is 180 degree. Again, so it's a linear pair. Again, BEC, and in place of BED, we have already proved that BED and BAD is equal because it's a opposite angles of a parallelogram. So here written from one end to we have written this one. Since if a pair of opposite angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degree, then the quadrilateral is a cyclic. So in that sense, we have proved that this angle plus this angle, angle A B C E, angle B C E means angle B C, this angle plus this angle is 180 degree. So hence it is a trapezium. Okay. So today this much only. Next day, if any other questions, if any doubt, you tell me, I'll make video to explain you.